What's up guys, in this tutorial I will show you how to fix the problem when your screen is randomly flickering on Windows 11. This should be quite an easy tutorial. For more information, click on the first link in the description below. The common screen flickering problem can be caused by different reasons, such as faulty hardware, outdated display drivers, or when using the wrong display settings. First, right-click your desktop to open up your display settings. On this window, select to use the correct display and make sure to use the recommended scale and display resolution. This can be especially helpful when using an abnormal native screen resolution. Below, click on Advanced Display and change your refresh rate. If it's set to 144, then lower it to the next option. While still in your settings, navigate to the Windows Update section. Click on Check for Updates and proceed to download the latest update before restarting your PC. This will not only fix software-related issues with your display, but also keep your drivers up to date and restart all processes running on your Windows PC. If the problem persists, then head back to your settings. Under System, click on Power and Battery. In the Power section, change your power mode. This is helpful if you have a dedicated graphics card or other power-intensive hardware. Next, open up your Device Manager. On this window, expand Monitors. Right-click the flickering monitor and select Update Driver. Select Search Automatically for Drivers, which will take a second to make sure that your display driver is up to date. When this is done, make sure that your graphics card driver is up to date. While in your Device Manager, expand Display Adapters. You can preview which kind of graphics card you are using. For NVIDIA GPU users, I suggest using the GeForce Experience application to update your graphics driver. AMD users can make use of the AMD Radeon software. On this window, navigate to the driver section and download the latest driver. This will automatically install the driver once it's downloaded. Lastly, you should make sure that you're not using a faulty display. Make sure that your cables and monitor work fine by testing each on a different system. In case you have any further issues or problems following this tutorial, then I suggest following my extensive guide linked in the description below. I hope this helped you out. Leave a comment if you have any questions and see you in the next one.